Hey everyone, it is Tuesday, June 12, 2012, or as Fiona likes to tag today, she's like, yes, it's 12-12-12.
Every now and then I say something very blonde. I know, I don't know why I'm thinking
it's December. Like you got a sudden gust of Eckford
Gosh, why would I think it's December with this sunny weather?
That is awesome,
no,
I love that.
No, it's terrible.
Lots of things going on. If you're on the West Coast today, you may have heard that there, unfortunately, this is a little bit sad, I believe it
it's
was a young humpback whale washed up on the beach in White Rock today. Lots of people out there. It was tangled in some fishing net. Very sad.
But you know what I read that was even sadder is that it had scars on its tail and the lower part of its body because it had been tangled in nets for the what they say is a very long time.
So we're not going to show it because we're classy like that, but it did remind one of our regular guests, Rick Yeager, our app man, sent me a video this morning that comes from the 1970s just down the coast from us in Washington State, where in 1970 they had a beach or a whale wash up on the beach and it had expired and their solution to it was to try and blow it up.
Man, the 70s were just a different time,
I believe
they?
The URL is explodingwhale.com or something around
Michael,
that.
Michael, don't direct people to
if you look up
you
exploding
were watching
whale.
It all morning thinking, nope. Look, they've got blubber all over them.
But it was the 70s. They didn't think things through
there
all
no
the way.
They just melts, everybody
they
smoked,
called in
and they
a guy,
blew up whales.
Exactly. They called in a guy from Highway Patrol and he's like, oh, you should probably blow this up. And everybody just went along with it.
It's the answer to everything in 1972.
Craziest video. Anyway, very sad, and people are going out there to check
don't
it out.
Don't be saccharine now.
I'm not endorsing blowing it up. I'm just saying.
You just think it's funny to watch, but sad to hear.
No, the video is crazy. The video is funny, not
the
because they blew up the whale,
right,
but because people are so stupid. That's what's funny about the video. It's not the whale. It's that humanity is replete with jackasses.
And here is the girl saying that it's 12-12-12 telling you that you're stupid.
Credibility disappeared fairly quickly. You had your eye exam yesterday.
I did.
Give me the report.
Okay.
We are both getting older. We need extendo arms.
I know.
Gadget.
I know. And I've been seeing the same eye doctor forever. Last time I saw him was 4 years ago was the last time I got my eyes tested. Dr. Faber says hi.
Okay, I wasn't sure whether we were supposed to say I know Dr. Faber's kids. I hang out with them.
I know. He says hello to you. And he didn't even get mad at me because I snuck my dog in my purse into the appointment because I was in such a rush. I couldn't take Chewy home. I felt terrible. I'm like, I'm in an eye doctor's office where people have allergies and stuff, though. And I said, Dr. Faber, I have a dog. He's like, what kind?
He's hypoallergenic.
And I said, a Yorkshire Terrier. He said, yeah, that's right. He goes, no one's allergic to those. And I said, you're right. Anyway, so he tested my eyes. It's, you know what? I get really nervous getting my eyes tested. And to answer your question, because we were wondering if they use the same chart. No, they don't. They have the ones that they use that are...
don't start telling me they use science now, Fiona, because I won't
believe
it.
They shift them around and get you to read different lines. But anyway, so he's switching the little doohinkies back and forth. And I'm
like, do they put the Roger Sterling acid in your eyes?
Yeah, they did.
So
the numbing ones so that they can rest. It's like Clockwork Orange. They rest that thing on your eyeball. I don't know why he does that.
Did he end up naked dancing in a chair looking at the New York
skyline? This is Dr. Faber.
Okay, I'm just
curious. Michael, have some respect.
If you watch Mad Men, you'll
one of the most respected ophthalmologists in our city.
Totally.
Anyway, he says you're hooped, Forbes.
Oh.
You know why I'm hooped?
You need glasses.
I'm hooped because, you know, I have trouble seeing my iPhone sometimes, but then I also complain, like, when the teleprompter is not close enough. Guess what? I'm both short-sighted and far-sighted.
You're hooped,
near-sighted,
Forbes.
Near-sighted, far-sighted? What is it I am? I'm
hooped.
Both. I'm losing both. And I went, so I'm going blind? Like, you're losing both. Isn't that blindness? Do I have to learn Braille? What's next?
So what, here, close your eyes. Feel is that an eye?
My body is in Braille. Okay, so here's
my
the
body's
thing.
In Braille.
Here's the thing. He said I'm not giving you glasses.
Do you have eye exercises?
He told me to go buy peepers at the drugstore.
Oh,
yeah.
You like bifocal style?
When I get glasses, I have to get bifocals. And he said, because you're on TV, I'm not going to do that to you yet. So I'm
awesome.
One of those people that's not even going to be able to get contact lenses. He said it's just very, very minor and I'm not getting glasses, so I'm going to annoy all of you just so you know. I still can't see anything.
Well, now that I know that,
wow.
I will not be getting my eye tested. So there you go.
No, but I mean, it doesn't mean you need bifocals.
Well, I'm scared now. That's the thing.
No, but I said, well, am I short-sighted or far-sighted?
Do we still have time to talk about the Stanley Cup playoffs? Last night, the Vancouver Canucks have made a habit of losing to the Stanley Cup winning team over the past number of seasons. Last night, The LA Kings fulfilled.
Except for last year, they waited until like game until seven and
yeah,
the final
still,
round.
Last night, the LA Kings, there's Dustin Brown, the second U.S. born captain to lift the Stanley Cup. One
guy
on this team that I'm happy for, Willie Mitchell, who
Willie
not only played
Mitchell.
Here, not only played here, but he is an excellent guy, very funny dude from Port McNeil over on Vancouver Island. So everyone in BC can be proud of his accomplishment. 15 guys on the LA roster. So,
but you know what? I still didn't care. I was having dinner at my girlfriend's place. Her son ran into the room and said, "Oh my God, there's 2 minutes left, and it's 6-1."
You know who was excited? Dustin Brown. He was interviewed just before he hoisted the Stanley Cup, and he had some very insightful and interesting things to say to Pierre LeBrun from NBC.
The second American-born captain ever have a chance to hoist the Stanley Cup. You're about to do it in a few seconds. In December, did you ever think that would happen?
You never know. I mean, you get to the dance, you never know what could happen. We got a run, and...
You know, only an NHL player could hawk a loogie in the middle of an interview and then just keep talking like and nothing then, happened.
And then, of course, swear like it's just...
Did he have his teeth in?
Yeah, well, he's missing, I think, one, maybe two. Oh. But he dropped a little F-bomb in there just for
all
the
right.
fun of it.
He just won the cup.
He's just a Canadian.
Okay, it is time to check in with Elise at Rock 101. Here she is.
Hey, guys. Well, this week on The Bro Jake Show, we've got a big ticket. It's not till November. But it is a big ticket because it's Neil Young, and not just Neil Young, he's finally back together with his band, Crazy Horse. So all week long, we're going to play a game called Name the Neil. All famous Neils, like yesterday we did Neil Armstrong, Neil Patrick Harris. What's it going to be for the rest of the week? You guess, you win.
Name the Neil. It's the game everyone's talking about. You can listen from 6 to 10. Usually we do the contesting around 7:50 mm-hmm. for the Neil Young
and
concert.
And I believe, speaking of names, there's a little bit of a correction.
Yes, it was Pierre Maguire, not Pierre LeBrun. I always get the two guys confused.
Me
because,
too.
You know, one's a Maguire, one's a LeBrun. So it's obvious that it's going to be easily to confuse.
Obviously. 12, 12, 12! We're going to take a break, and when we return...